Great. Hello, everyone. Thanks for joining us today. We're really excited to do a bit of movement and dancing today. So we may have met some of you so far in our live sessions, or perhaps you saw our last recording. If so, welcome back. If not, really happy to meet you today, and perhaps we'll meet you in person soon. My name's Alisa.
My name is Claire. I'm really excited to get to dance with you all today. Just wanted to mention that the space we're meeting you in is this virtual space that gives us the opportunity to connect and move together. And we also wanted to acknowledge the physical embodied space that we're in with our bodies. So we're encouraging taking moments throughout the class to look at the space you're in, see what's around you, just to really ground our bodies where we are today. We'll be playing some music throughout the workshop. Please feel free, if you'd rather, to mute us and just do your own music, do your own movement, whatever feels good for your body. Otherwise, and you can just follow along our visual cues. Otherwise, we encourage you to join us with the music and our guidance with our voices. We do not own the rights to this music. It's for creative purposes only.
Great.
And, I guess we'll pass it off to Alisa for just to give you a little heads up about what to expect today for the movement.
Great. So so we're going to be taking part in a bit of creative movement, a bit of kind of physical sensing and mindfulness, some breathing, a bit of accessible yoga, and lots of kind of free movement and dance to music. And there'll be the opportunity to share. Of course, we can't see you today, but we still hope to be able to take part in some virtual sharing anyway. And just to say that this class is all about accessibility. We're all showing up to the class today in our own bodies, feeling, you know, differently in each moment. So just take what works for you, leave the rest. We'll be showing a variety of options and variations. So just follow whatever works for you. And if you prefer to just do your own thing, that's also totally fine. It's all about feeling good and having fun. So with that, I think we're gonna get started. So I'll just take a moment to notice the space that we're in. So take a break from watching the screen and look around your room. Maybe you're sharing the space with someone. You can give them a little smile or a nod. Maybe you have some pets. Maybe you're all alone and you can just take in some of the colors and textures, the lighting. You might notice the temperature of the room, the feeling of the chair you're sitting on. I think Claire gave her cat a little pet. You might notice any sort of scent or sound. So just tuning into the space you're in today and just noticing. And when you feel ready, we're gonna sink into our bodies a bit. So we're seated on chairs today. So if possible, you can come to the edge of your chair to have a long spine. You can have your feet planted in the ground, but just sit in a way that's comfortable for you. And I'd like to invite you to close your eyes or have a soft gaze. And just noticing your breath and any sensations or thoughts that arise. You can take a moment to take a few intentional breaths, breathing in through the nose and releasing out through the mouth. You can sigh, this feels good. Breathing in the energy of the practice today and breathing out the day thus far, the day to come. Just connecting with your body in this moment. You might begin to notice any sensations in your body, perhaps there's some pain or discomfort that's sort of coming to the forefront. You can notice these sensations. If it helps, you can breathe into these spaces. And again, sigh out. So we're just noticing and acknowledging these sensations, not trying to change anything. And then we'd like to just take a moment to draw our attention to an opposite sort of sensation. So as opposed to any constriction, tension, or pain, you might notice any feelings of spaciousness or lightness in your body, or perhaps warmth. So this might be in the tips of your fingers or your toes, your ribs, maybe your chest. And breathing into these, noticing and appreciating these sensations. Noticing if you can bring this feeling of spaciousness or lightness into other areas of the body. And taking a moment to notice your breath. Notice any movement it brings into your body. Perhaps your chest rising and lowering, your belly moving in and out. Noticing if you feel your breath along your back and your sides as well. And I'm just going to take us through a small body scan. So starting along the roof of the head, noticing any sensations in the crown of the head, down into the face, releasing any tension along the forehead or the jaw. Noticing sensations along the neck and the throat, the chest, the shoulders, the arms, elbows, wrists and hands. Breathing into these spaces. Noticing the sensations along the abdomen, down along the spine, the shoulder blades, all the way down into the hips and the pelvis. And then following the sensations along the legs and the knees, the lower legs, the ankles and the feet rooting into the floor. And noticing the body as a whole. And when you feel ready, just averting your eyes from the screen, you can cover your eyes or you can turn away from the screen, just blinking your eyes open. Again, seeing the space around you and moving in whatever way feels good for you today. So you might want to stretch your arms up above your head or out to the sides. You might want to take a bit of a swaying motion. You can roll your head side to side or your shoulders. You might want to take your weight from side to side on your hips and your sit bones. You can also stretch your legs out. And breathing, you can take some yawns if this feels good. We're just waking up the body. Wonderful. And I think we're gonna come into a bit of self-massage now. I'm gonna pass things on to Claire. And for anyone who doesn't want to do any massage work, I'm gonna lead some alternative light stretches. So choose to move in whatever way works for you.
Wonderful. So I invite you to rub your hands together to build up some warmth. And I'm going to imagine washing my face with this warmth. Alternatively, it can be a coolness that you envision coming along the face, just pulling downwards, help release some of those muscles and the tension we can carry in the facial muscles here. And I'm going to take the tips of my fingers, just pulling outwards from the center of the forehead, along the temples, brushing down along either side of the nose, and then under the eyes, along the cheekbones. Just following the flow of my facial structure. Follow for yourself what feels best. And for me, I'm coming down to my jaw, releasing my jaw. Alisa's showing some great breath work and jaw release options. I'm just gonna open and close my jaw with my hands, so releasing any work in the jaw. And I'm just going to bring the tips of my fingers either side, just in front of my ears where my jaw joint begins. I'm just massaging in circles either way. And I'm going to bring this down along either side of my neck in the front. Pulling downwards. This is a great massage for the tongue, going right underneath the jaw. Using the fingertips or the thumbs, as is comfortable for yourself. And just massaging along here. An alternative is the doing neck motions up and down, like Alisa is showing. And I'm going to lean my head forward and just taking my fingertips, moving them from the front of my head to the back and the crown of my head. A brushing motion just to bring awareness into the head and the skin around the hairline. This is really great for the muscles that are underneath and the connections. Everything connects in the body. So doing a little bit of this can help along the entire spine. Great. And then I'm going to just massage along the back of my neck. You can do some nice side to side neck circles that Alisa's showing. It's a great option to warm up these muscles here. And I'm going to bring this into my upper shoulders here, just pulling forward with my hands. And I'm going to switch to just one arm at a time, but you can do both as well. And Alisa's got some great shoulder circles there. And I'm just squeezing with my hand right now, just pulling at any muscles that need attention. If there's something that feels good for you, I invite you to stay with it and take your time. And I'm going to squeeze along my shoulder and imagine that I have a tube of toothpaste. I'm squeezing down the tension from all the way out of my arm and pulling it out of the tips of my fingers. Tension is released. And finding mobilization in the joints of the arm is another alternative. And on the other side, I'm going to squeeze along the shoulder and then squeeze that tension all the way down from the top of the arm to the bottom, pulling at the tips of the fingertips to release that tension. Nice, and I'm gonna shake that off. And then a little hand massage moment. I'm just gonna take my hands and using my thumb, I'm just going to press into the palm of my hand and just push outwards again, following up to each fingertip, just creating a little bit more space in the hand. Alisa's showing a really awesome option that you can do, opening and closing the fists of the hands to feel that space being created between all of the joints and the bones in the hand. There's a lot going on in here, and we use our hands a lot. It can be good to give them some attention. And on the other hand, opening up that palm with the thumb, just massaging along the palm. You can get along the back of the hand as well at the same time with the tips of your fingers. And it's a great, some wrist mobilization that Alisa's showing. All of this will help to warm up the joints, create some more space in the body, and release tension. Wonderful. Great, I'm gonna shake that off. I'm going to take the tips of my fingers to my collarbone. So I'm going to pull downwards with one hand on one side, switching, doing some breath work, moving up and down is another great option of extension, opening up the collarbone a bit and the heart space that Alisa is showing for you. Then I'm going to bring this down my sternum, so feeling the bone of my sternum to my rib cage. I'm just gonna take the palms of my hands now and just find for yourself whatever method feels best in the ribs. So for me right now, that's a brushing motion with the palms of my hand. And I'm gonna lean forward into the ribs in the back space using fists as well as in the front space. Alisa's showing some awesome side stretching. These are a great way to also wake up this part of the body. And just finding whatever feels good here. Just bringing awareness to the ribs, giving it a bit of touch to notice the sensations here or motion in the body. All equally will allow you to feel the sensations going on. I'm noticing that I'm a bit more sore in my back space along the ribs than in my front space. So that helps me to know to focus a bit more on this back space today during this class. And I'm going to pass it off to Alisa now to you guiding us through this non-touch option of waking up the body and getting some space into it.
Great. So as Claire said, I've just been doing a little bit of mobilizing in the torso. So extending the spine and looking up and contracting and looking down, coming into flexion. And then I did a few side bends as well. You can do with this with the arm raised or lowered, right? And now going into stretching the back a bit more, I'm just gonna reach up and roll forward through my spine. So just letting the head go, bringing the weight into the feet, rolling through the spine. You can give your shoulders a little shimmy. Breathing into the back. If you do want to have a bit of a touch, you can give it a bit of a rub like Claire's doing. And then rolling back up. Let's do this once more. So breathing in and rolling forward. Now you don't have to come all the way down. It could just be an ever so slight little wave. In and out. In and out. And now as I'm down here, I have my hands on my legs. I'm gonna just take a slight twist with my hand on my right thigh, turning, breathing in, and a slight turn the other way. And in. And turn, and you could do this upright if that's better for you, or leaning forward a bit, right? So I'm just stretching these long muscles along the back. Great. So we're gonna come into our hips now. So let's just do a little bit more of this movement we were doing with the spine, but we're gonna focus on our hips. So we're coming forward with our hips, leaning into our feet and rolling back up. And you can let it tilt. Okay. So playing with what it feels like to tilt your hips a little forward and back. They might not have much movement in them, and that's all right. Just see what it feels like to move them around a bit. Again, noticing the breath. Okay. And now I'm gonna experiment with shifting my weight from side to side. So my right sit bone is coming just ever so slightly off, and I'm putting the weight into my other leg. So just a little shifting side to side, raising up the hip. And as I do this, I feel the weight going into one foot and then over to the other. And Claire's experimenting with this in standing. So you can do the same thing shifting the weight from foot to foot. Right, so we're bringing a bit of mobility into our hips here. And now we're gonna do some circles with our torso. So I'm leaning forward, to the right, back, and side. Okay. And again, this can be done standing. Just doing some nice little circles and switching directions. Feeling the weight traveling along your sit bones and your pelvis. And just working out any areas of tension here. These can be really small movements. Okay, now we're coming down to the knees. I'll bring it up so you can see my face. Let's take a moment to extend our knees, right? So they may not come very high and it may not straighten all the way, but you can lean back and hold on to your chair so you have a bit of support. And just experiment with straightening and bending your knee. I'm gonna do the other one. Good. Oh yeah, Claire has a really good option for holding the leg and letting it swing a bit. That feels quite nice. And you can do little circles as well. Really good. I'm gonna shake my legs out. All right, so we're coming down to our ankles and our feet now. So I'm gonna do this in sitting, but we could do it standing as well. So just coming up, raising your heel and coming up onto your metatarsal there. Doesn't need to be a big movement, just down and up, down and up. And Claire's doing a nice foot massage. This can feel really nice. Working out any tension and switching to my other foot here. Really good. Okay. And now I'm gonna do some little circles with my foot. So it might feel nice to hold your knee. This might help. And just circling in each direction. And then taking a moment to roll through the toes. You might hear some little clicks, just kind of getting a bit of motion into these feet. Okay, let's do the other one. So some little circles in either direction. You can also do a bit of up and down and side to side and moving the toes around. Great. You can shake that out again. Wonderful. So hopefully you're feeling pretty warmed up. I'm gonna pass it back to Claire now.
Great. I definitely feel in my body a bit more space and awareness of the sensations in the different areas of the joint. I'm going to do a little bit of a free movement moment. Just find any other movement that you may need to find in your body that it's asking for. Taking this time, if there's anything else that needs a little more attention. I'm noticing my shoulders wanted a little bit more movement. So I'm just taking a moment there. Wonderful. And now we're going to do some more active stretching. So I'm going to invite us to begin with the upper body. And as always, feel free to adjust what you need to. And Alisa will show some options that don't require using the arms above the head. So I'm going to breathe in and reach up. And sign that out and down. Breathing in, reaching up. Sighing out, coming down. Breathe in. And breathe out. Breathing in. Breathing out. And I'm going to reach one arm overhead, leaning to the side. And I'm going to imagine painting the ceiling and the sky with this. Finding an opening and a closing of the shoulder. a great option. Alisa's showing is with the arm down. Great. And on the other side, I'm reaching up and then painting the ceiling with my arm to bring an opening and a closing of the shoulder joint. Wonderful. And now I'm going to come up and reach both of my arms out in front of me, bring them into a hug, breathing in, sighing it out, and releasing tension in the shoulder. Alisa has a great option that you can do if you do not want to bring your arms fully around the body, or if there's a tightness there, to just keep them at a softness or an untouched option, crossed in front of the body. Breathing in, releasing the shoulders downwards as we breathe out. And switching the arm that is on top. I'm reaching my arms out, bringing them over the body and squeezing in. Breathing in, dropping the shoulders down, breathing out. Alisa has a nice bend in her knees as we're breathing out and breathing in. This is a great option if you're standing. Finding some contraction and extension in the spine. And I'm going to release that. I'm going to follow this motion of expansion and contraction in the spine, letting my belly button guide me in this movement. So starting from the belly button, I contract in. Starting from the belly button,
right,
open up. Wonderful. We've got more energetic music coming our way soon.
Wonderful. That was, sorry, everyone. That was amazing.
Just the day in the life of technology. All right. I'm going to invite us to do a gentle twist in the spine, encouraging you to only go as far as is comfortable. To begin, I'm going to root down into my feet or my sit bones and really lengthen my spine. I'll use my arms above my head to encourage this motion. You can do it as well with the arms rested. Breathing in, breathing out, I'll drop the arms if they aren't down already. And feeling that length, I'm just going to bring one arm across my body to my opposite leg and just gently allow myself to look over my shoulder as far as is comfortable, using that breath. Breathing in, lengthening the spine, breathing out, releasing any tension. Breathing in and breathing out. Switching sides, I'm going to come back to center. Lisa's showing a great option there. If you're standing, using the hands on the torso to help guide us. So I'm going to bring my hand across the opposite leg. And then looking over my shoulder, I'm going to breathe in, lengthening my spine. Breathing out, finding release. Breathing in, I'm breathing out. I'm not forcing any movement, just allowing myself to land where I am today with where my body is at today. And I'm gonna come back to center. Great. We're going to do a little bit of a game that those of you who have joined us will be familiar with. And if not, it's pretty straightforward. So we'll be able to share with you the steps and you can practice up for next week's live session. So the name is called the name game. The game is focused around sharing and getting to bring out our own movements individually for sharing within the group. The way it works is one of us will share our name and a movement that feels just relevant to us today. And then everyone else will repeat the person's name and their movement. So Alisa and I can show you how it works. So, hi, my name is Claire, and my movement today is
this. And then we can say, hi, Claire. And mirror that movement back. Great. Lovely. And then usually we try a few different variations. So if you don't want to move the arms too much, they could just be a smaller version, just keeping them nice and low. Or you could even just do the part with the spine and the face. And as I'm standing, I'm sort of mirroring that coming up and down by straightening and bending my knees. So these are some things you can think about. I'll share mine now. So hi, my name is Alisa. And my movement today is...
Ooh, wonderful. Hi, Alisa. And some great options with this one can just be the torso. It's getting that gentle twist we just worked on. Or just the arms.
Exactly. If you're standing, I'm feeling it in my hips. It's a bit of a hip shimmy. And there's also a bit of a, you could do a bigger version, a bit of a swim. Great.
So I'd like to take this time now to offer some space for anyone who wants to share their own movement and their name and just movement, if you know your name. So we're going to just do some movements in silence and give that space if you're doing this class with another person or a pet or a rock that's a good companion, anyone that you want to share your name to. I would encourage that. It can feel valuable to get to take space for ourselves for a moment. Or to yourself, just offering this gift to yourself of doing some movement and acknowledging it and taking some time to be present with that movement. So here we go. We'll do some silent movements for a moment while you play the name game.
Does Rhapsody have a movement? Oh.
Yeah, I think she does. It is called face scratches. And then jumping. Great, awesome. So I think we're ready to carry on. We're going to do this a couple more times, but with different focuses each time. So I'm going to choose a movement based off of a color. So my movement is inspired by the color green. This is my movement.
Feels quite vine-like to me.
Yeah,
climbing I can see a tree
outside the window.
Yeah,
I admit I'm inspired by nature.
Really good. Okay, so a color. Let's see. I see a nice turquoise blue in a picture on the wall. It makes me feel quite, airy.
That's nice. And again, can always do that with just the torso or just the arms.
I'm sort of swinging forward onto the balls of my feet and back onto my heels. That's how I'm bringing that sway into it. Mm-hmm.
So again, nice. Elise and I will do another round, but in silence. We promise it'll be in silence this time. The cat won't be taking the spotlight. She does her own class on weekends. And we'll give you a moment to just notice a color and find some movement inspired by that. So here we go.
Nice. It's also always an option to bring a bit of sound into your movement. I felt like that one was one that could have been like tinkle, 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 or something. Some movement.
I imagine that vocal
energy.
Vocalization is great. That one makes me think of like,
yeah, that's
like
cool.
A bird.
That's nice. Yeah.
Speaking actually of sound, I think we could probably pop on some of our instrumental music as our background, since we've got space and silence.
Great.
So we're going to do this game one more time. That's awesome. Thanks, Alisa. So this time, I'm going to be inspired by a shape. And the shape that's inspiring me is an object in this room I'm in. I'm going to take a moment actually to look around my room to just see the space I'm in. And then the shape that is inspiring me, I'm going to do some footwork.
Nice.
You could do this with the hands alternatively. You could do both. Bit of a mental work.
I'm trying not to move forward too much. No. What was the shape?
It was a ladder.
Oh, cool. That's nice. All right, shape. Okay. Here we go.
Intriguing. I'm curious what the shape is. Let me guess. Is it a cylinder?
Yeah, it's a fan.
yep, that's good. It's a good. Oh yeah,
it's in the
very
cylindrical fan, not a round fan. Yeah.
We can even do this with just our head as well. Awesome. So we'll do it again in silence to give you some opportunities to come up with your own movement and your own shape. Okay.
I'll do yours.
All right. All right. Yep.
That was not a cat, but it looked like a cat.
That's great. All movement is beautiful. And it's meant to have fun. That's what's great about these games is you can come up with some really, really fun movement. So thanks for joining us on this this activity. Alisa, how are you feeling in terms of doing a little choreography next or doing some mirroring?
Yeah, I mean, I'm happy with either. Should we jump into a bit of choreography?
It is feeling kind of more the right moment for that, I would say.
Good.
Since we've just created a bunch of movements.
Yeah, exactly. Good.
You're right. So we're going to take the game we just played and we're going to make a little choreography phrase together. So a phrase of choreography is just a string of movements attached together, and then that's a phrase. So I invite you to use the movement that you also use what we have done as well. So I think maybe we can just pick some of our favorite movements we just did. And we're going to take turns sharing movement, and it's going to build up to be a phrase of movement. So Alisa, do you have a movement you would like to propose?
Sure, yes. I think this one I will start with.
Great.
We can go both ways, maybe.
Nice, yeah. Okay, great. So we've got one side, other side. Then maybe from there, I'm going to propose we do this open arm.
Nice.
Great. So to put those two together, we've got flying hand, smooth.
Oh, so did you do, sorry, doesn't matter. Did you alternate arms both each time?
I did left arm, right arm, and then using that same right arm, I've done my
circle. Cool.
Wonderful. Alternated. That's totally fine too. We can have two versions. That's great. Awesome. All right, Alisa's turn.
All right. Trying to think of what movements I had before. Well, there's this one.
This is true. This is great.
So if anyone's interested in what I'm doing with my feet, it's a little shuffle.
And we can also do that seated if we want. We can just
do that. Brings a little bit of percussion to the mix.
Yeah. Very nice. Okay, so from the beginning we have swimming, both sides, smooth. And what would we shuffle? We've got our shuffle.
Yeah, so maybe we can just shuffle out of it and go the other way.
Yeah. Shuffle right out of it. Great. Yeah. Invite anyone right now, if they have their own movement, to insert your own movement into this next moment, if you would like. Otherwise, you can keep following our suggestions. I'm going to actually do a new movement now, just because I'm feeling it. Actually, no, I really liked this. I'm going to bring this in. We'll call this the pounce.
Yeah,
not cat inspired at all.
it was like a French press coffee, but I think the tip, you know, it's the coffee coming out. Yeah,
it's great. Could be a cat, could be a coffee maker.
Yeah,
endless possibilities. All right, so from the beginning, we have swimming into smooth, and we shuffle. And we shuffle back to the center and pounce. Oh yeah, I liked actually what Alisa did there. We do a little side pounce.
Side pounce. Oh,
sorry.
Yeah.
Side coffee making. Great.
That's great. Do you want to try that much with music?
Let's do that. And as always, encouraging anyone that wants to add in their own movement, we would normally go in a circle and everyone would get the chance to share a movement to contribute. So feel free to do that. Instead of using our movements, if you'd rather, but also if you like our moves, feel free to use them.
So Claire, you make my dreams come true, or ain't no mountain high enough?
Let's do ain't no mountain high enough.
Yeah. Okay, great.
So we're just going to play some music and we're just going to repeat our phrase a few times.
Is that a good level?
That's great. You need me, call me, no matter where you are, no matter how far.
Maybe we can wait for the chorus. Just a little freestyle to the chorus. Yeah. You don't have to worry, cause baby, there ain't no
mountain high enough. Ain't no mountain high enough. Ain't no mountain high enough. Great! All right. So you can just keep freestyling until that chorus comes back, and we'll do our phrase with the chorus.
Here we go.
Win. Other side. Shuffle.
Nice.
All Awesome.
Maybe double time?
Yeah, let's double time it. Let's see what happens. Could be a disaster, could be fantastic. Here we go. Oh, just kidding, we're doing this anyways. Yeah. We can try that again.
Yeah.
Other side. Shuffle. Freestyle. Amazing.
Good work, everyone.
That's great. That's our choreography phrase. And you can do this with any movement. Just put some movements together and then just dance it as you'd like. Awesome. And I think on that note, it's time to do a little mirroring dance party.
Yeah.
Alisa, would you like to describe what we're going to do and guide us through?
Yeah, of course. So basically, it's quite similar to what we were doing at the beginning, just without any words and with music. So we're going to take turns sharing movements and mirroring them sort of in the moment. So just like a little dance party, really. So if we could see you, we would invite you to take a turn to share if you wanted, but maybe sometime in person. But if you have someone with you, you can take turns leading with each other. And that's what Claire and I will do. We'll take turns leading and you can follow along or come up with your own movements with the person who's with you. So should be just a bit of fun, really. All right, so we're gonna put on another fun song and get going. Everyone.
Yeah. Great work, everyone. Hope you enjoyed dancing with us there, and or had your own dance moves to jam to. Either way, it's been a real good time, and we're gonna just do a little cool down now to close off this session.
Yeah. So I guess just to get started, let's just stretch out whatever needs stretching, like we did at the beginning, reaching up or out, side to side, just moving in a way that feels good for you, making sure to breathe. Good, we're gonna bring in, I'm gonna stand just so that we can take a few turns. We're gonna bring in a little bit of a sway. Moving side to side, letting your head go. Following the movements, just like your seaweed swaying in the water. If you're standing, your knees are nice and soft. And then just slowly bringing the movement into a smaller movement until you're still. And then we're gonna do a bit of a forward and back sway. This one's quite good if you're seated. You can just let yourself come forward with your chin and then roll up with your chin coming up last. If you're standing, your knees are nice and bent. And then I'm gonna take this opportunity to stretch my arms up above my head and breathe in. You can bring them out to the side if that's better, and down through the center, breathing out, releasing, breathing in and out and in and out. Great. Okay, I'm gonna come to seated now with Claire and bring one hand to your chest and one to your belly, if that feels good for you, or just on your lap. Bringing your eyes to a close, feeling your heart beating, feeling your blood moving through your veins. Feeling your chest rising and lowering and your belly moving in and out. Noticing what feels different from how you felt at the beginning of class. I feel much warmer, a little bit sweaty. I feel a little, some kind of tingles along my body. I feel like my sensations are a little bit more alive. Now you may feel good differences. Maybe something feels different that isn't good. That's okay as well. Just acknowledging the sensations in this moment. Feeling your sit bones against the chair, your feet rooted to the floor. And when you feel ready, without looking at the screen, you can blink your eyes open. Take in the space around you. Noticing anyone you might be sharing the space with, or anything that's changed in the space. Perhaps the lighting is different. Maybe the smells or the sounds are different. And when you're ready, you can bring your attention back to the shared space that we're in. And I'd like to thank you for joining us today. I wonder if maybe if anyone has a word or something they'd like to share about how you feel or what you got out of this session. So I'm going to share a word and also a gesture with Claire. So I feel energized. Yeah, and my motion will be Right. Thanks. I'm going to give Claire a chance to share.
I feel laughter. This is my movement.
It's really nice.
And feel free to take this moment to share your own movement and your own word out loud to yourself or with another. Both are equally powerful, to just name what we feel and take that space to honor that. And that said, I'd like to take a moment to thank each and everyone who's participating in this video. We wouldn't be here if it weren't for all of you. So thank you for sharing and movement with us and taking space to join us in this adventure of the body. We'll be back next week doing a live session, looking forward to that with you all. And then these videos will be available on the YouTube page for quite some time. So you can feel free to come and do them again as many times as you'd like, to repeat, to do your own variations and just have fun with them.
Wonderful. Thanks so much for coming today and hope to see you soon. Go gently into your day. Thank you. Bye.